He was here for only three seasons, but what a time that was in Detroit's hockey history. Mike Vernon was a huge part of the creation of a dynasty. He and Ozzie shared the goaltending duties for much of that time, but it was Vernon who led the way when the Wings were on the very edge of being very good. And when they won the Cup in 97, Mike Vernon was the Conn Smythe winner as the playoff MVP. We can say this with some assurance, when he comes back to town, Mike Vernon will never have to pay for another drink in this town again. That comes with being a playoff hero when a team hasn't won a Stanley Cup in 42 years. Mickey Redmond is alongside. Ozzie's here, Vernie. But as we begin, I would like you to tell me your best Chris Osgood story.
Be nice, Vernie. Be nice.
Oh, boy. There are a lot of them. This one isn't really hockey related. This was
of course it's not.
Chris moved into Birmingham and created his house for him through a magazine and helped him out and things like that. But
we apologize for some technical difficulties. Vernie's in Calgary, Alberta,
been a lot
so we
of
have
good
some
memories,
some transmission issues. So. All right, Mick, you want to try Vernie? You got a question for him?
I do. Mike, do you remember, did you room with Ozzie in the old days when before guys had their own room by 400 games and all that stuff? And if you did, who had control of the TV monitor thing, the whatever you call it?
The remote.
The remote. Who had control of the remote, you or Ozzie?
I don't know. We might have roomed a bit together, but generally by that time they started giving goaltenders their own rooms and things like
and
that.
Bernie, we did room together, and then
I don't know. I was probably sound asleep, and Ozzie was still playing video games or something.
You forget, and I was rooming with you, I think, a couple years, and then the third year when we won, Scotty accused me of being a distraction to you, which is completely ironic, and I was shocked when I called into the office and he said, "Chris, you're out of Mike's room because you're too much of a distraction. I'm the distraction." I was like taken back. Dave Lewis was in tears laughing in the background, and I was out of your room, and then you went on to win the Conn Smythe and helped us win the Stanley Cup, obviously. So obviously Scotty knew what he was doing off the ice as well, and there we are right there. What a photo that is. Wow.
That's a great picture. Oh, my God. Isn't
Ozzie,
that great? What a memory.
Ozzie,
look at that.
That's
Ozzie,
before
do
the
you
crown.
Remember when we were in...
Go ahead.
Remember when we were in L.A. and Scotty came up to us and he goes, "Who can I play tonight? You guys are both awful against L.A. Do I have to call Kevin Hodgson up to play the game?"
Well,
and then he said, "Ozzie, you're playing tonight. Vernon, you get San Jose." And he turned around and skated away.
Well, I remember he told, we both got caught in the net a few times. Obviously, I have, and so did you. And then he told us to stay in the net. He told Jacques Plante, and I've told Bernie Perron, or whoever he said, I've told them to stay in the net. I'm going to tell you two to stay in the net. We're in L.A. in the old form. You come out of the net off the faceoff from center to start the game. Somebody dumps in and hits the partition and goes into the net. Scotty sees me, runs down the bench, and starts lecturing me. And giving it to me when it was you that led in the goal.
He had Jacques Plante in St. Louis and Glenn Hall together in 1967 and 68 and 69. All two of both those guys, those Hall of Famers, together, Ozzie.
Yeah, but we did room together. We almost missed a plane once as well, so there was a lot of stuff going on there.
Oh, man. Bernie, when you think back to 1997 and all those Hall of Famers that were in front of you, what are the great memories that you remember from that year? Getting to the Stanley Cup in 97.
The teammates. I mean, we had such a strong lineup throughout, and just how we came together as a team. And I you know, it's been brought up before, the fight against Colorado and the brawl and things like that. But that really united our hockey club, and we were fighting for each other, and it showed the way we were playing on the ice. And, you know, Larry Onoff and Forsberg were the ones that basically started the brawl, and then it went from there. But that really gelled our hockey club together, and they just continued after that. And even after I left, they continue winning cups and the winning ways.
Speaking of the brawl, that night, do you have any idea, or at what point in time did you realize that you had to go with Patrick Waugh, Mike.
Well, I wasn't too excited about Patrick leaving his crease. And, you know, as soon as he left his crease, I knew I had to leave my crease and participate in it. And I think the first guy I kind of grab onto is one of the big defensemen, Adam Foote, for Colorado. Yep. And he kind of looked at me and kind of shook his head. And then, I don't know, soon enough, Patrick Waugh had kind of jumped me. And then we kind of squared off and hit each other a few times, and that was it. I've never been so exhausted in my whole life.
You must have caught him with a pretty good right or a left.
I remember.
He had blood everywhere.
That was a left, Mick, right away.
Well, I got a left. It was a little razor blade. But no.
Or something else, yeah. I could mention.
I remember. and then I remember going into the dressing room, and I was fatigued. I was done. And Chris came in the dressing room and said, yeah, you got to go back on the ice. I go, I have to be kicked out of this game. I left the crease. I got in a fight. They have to eject me from this game. And it was, and I was not playing well at that time. I think I already let in 5 goals or something like this. And I got dressed and I went back onto the ice, and we finished the game. We actually came back and won that game. And little did I know, that was my 300th victory that game.
Yeah, well,
so
yeah.
It was a pretty meaningful game for me.
Isn't it no coincidence that as we go down the road this far away, you were the first guy to go after Patrick or have to go with him, but you weren't alone. Our other guy had to go with him too. Isn't this great stuff?
And absolutely.
And like you and I, Vernie, we have no idea how this happened or how we got there. All of a sudden, these things just happen. People don't believe them. Believe us, but this is it right here. And Vernie, I was the same as you. He's a big guy. I have never fought before. That's my first ever fight.
Really?
I'd had more wrestling matches with you in the hotel room, Vernie, than I have playing with these guys.
Oh, my God. Ozzy, I don't know, how the heck didn't you go down, Ozzy, with all those rights he was throwing at you?
No,
you held your own, and you finally got him down. I'll never forget it. The crowd went nuts.
It's just tons of ab work. If you've ever checked my abs,
you could take it, couldn't you?
It's all about the core.
Ab work.
No, I have no idea
classic.
What was going on there. It was
classic
a lot of fun
stuff.
Those days.
Oh my
awesome
God.
Stuff.
Vernie, how special was it to have the Russian Five playing in front of you, especially when they began to click in the season that you won it all?
Well, it was a lot better being on the same team with them than against. I recall if we ever had a 5-on-3, Scotty would put out the 5 Russians and the opposition wouldn't touch the puck for a minute and 50 seconds. And then they'd, you know, set it up for Constantine to come from the point towards the net. They'd feed him and he'd usually score goals. So it was kind of embarrassing when they got the puck because they would never let anybody touch it, and they were so talented and gifted players, and Larionov and Connie, they were all great players and a big part of the Red Wing organization at that time.
Yeah, Vernie, I remember I watched in Montreal. I had 2 hot dogs. I was standing hot dogs, by the way. You played the game, and it was Patrick Waugh's last game. And I remember the Russian Five were unbelievable that game. He didn't have much of a chance in any of those. But I'm wondering, like, you fight Patrick Waugh, and I fought Patrick Waugh. You beat him in the finals, only goalie to ever win the Stanley Cup on the Montreal Forum ice versus Montreal. And yet I hear these rumors you're having coffee with him away from the rink. Is this true?
No, it wasn't. It was before the game, and I went to this little breakfast spot that we always go to. And I walk in there, and Patrick was sitting there, and there was a seat beside him that was available. And he sees me, waves me over, and I'm like, I don't want to go talk to him. And so I go down there, and he was pretty distraught. The fans were on him. He was a local guy. He wasn't happy. He was talking about quitting the game, and it was very stressful for him. And I told him I was in the same situation here at Calgary with the Flames and things like that. And I said, you don't need to quit. Just get traded. And it's done wonders for me going to Detroit and things like that. And sure enough, after that game, he marched over to Corey, the president, that sat behind the bench, and I'm sure he whispered to him, I'll never play another game again. And I think it was 2 days later, he was traded to that Colorado Avalanche. So it's and then he went on to win another three cups after that. So
I guess he did
the right thing.
We're delighted that you found your way to Detroit, even though it was only for three seasons. We appreciate your time. Enjoy the Wings and the Predators tonight along with everybody else. The great Mike Vernon joining us from his home in Calgary. Ken and Mick take over next. Game Time is coming up on a Thursday night and here on Fox Sports Detroit.